Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My beloved brothers and sisters, this is Sunan al-Tirmidhi, which is also referred to as Al-Jami' al-Kabir, written by Al-Imam Abi Isa Muhammad ibn Isa ibn Sawrah al-Tirmidhi, who died the year 279 Hijriya. This is the second volume, and the taba'a that I'm using, the publication, is Darul Ta'asil, which is the best publication out there right now, alhamdulillah. It is the best copy with the least mistakes. And I was reading the second volume as I was preparing for my explanation of Kitab al-Sifat, written by Imam al-Daruqutni, rahimahullah. And so I came to the chapter where the author, rahimahullah, this kitab is Kitab Babu Ma Ja'a Fi Fadli Sadaqah, the chapter that came regarding the virtues of Sadaqah. And Imam al-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah, he brings a hadith here, which he says, from his own chain of narration, of course, Abu Quray Muhammad ibn al-Ala, قال حدثنا يعني وكيع ابن جراح الرؤاسي قال حدثنا عباد ابن منصور قال حدثنا القاسم بن محمد قال سمعت أبا هريرة يعني عبد الرحمن بن صخر الدوسي يقول قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله يقبل الصدقة ويأخذها بيمينه. So here there's a hadith used here which falls under the chapters known as hadith al-sifat, Allah's characteristics and attributes. وَيَأْخُذُهَا بِيَمِينِهِ. So Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah, one of the beneficial things about his book is that he actually has ta'liqat and some points that he mentions. So sometimes he speaks slightly different from some of the other a'imma who don't really have much says in their books. But he says something, so inshallah ta'ala I'm going to read the statement on you, but I'm not going to explain it inshallah ta'ala, but I'll explain the last part inshallah ta'ala. He says, وَقَدْ قَالَ غَيْرُ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ فِي هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ وَمَا يُشْبِهُهُ هَذَا مِنَ الرِّوَايَاتِ هَذَا مِنَ الرِّوَايَاتِ مِنَ الصِّفَاتِ وَنُزُولِ الرَّبِّ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. قَالُوا بَلْ ثَبَتَتِ الرِّوَايَاتُ فِي هَذَا وَيُؤْمَنُ بِهَا وَلَا يُتَوَهَّمُ وَلَا يُقَالُ كَيْفَ هَكَذَا رُوِيَ عَن مَالِكِ بْنِ أَنَسٍ وسفيان بن عيينة وعبد الله بن المبارك أنهم قالوا في هذه الأحاديث أمروها بلا كيف وهكذا قول أهل العلم من أهل السنة والجماعة وأما الجهمية. So he brings all the statement of the أئمة السنة, الإمام مالك بن أنس, سفيان بن عيينة, عبد الله بن المبارك, that all of them they said أمروها, go over it بلا كيف وهكذا قول أهل العلم من أهل السنة. So that's the view of أهل السنة. All of that is what أهل السنة والجماعة believe regarding what? Regarding أحاديث الصفات. Now he goes into the deviated group which are the جهمية. So what do the جهمية do? So he said, وأما الجهمية فأنكرت هذه الروايات. So as for the جهمية, they rejected these narrations. وقالوا, they said, هذا تشبيه. If we affirm these characteristics, we're going to fall into تشبيه, resembling the creator with the creation. وَقَدْ ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى فِي غَيْرِ مَوْضِعٍ مِّنْ كِتَابِهِ الْيَدَ وَالسَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ. And he says Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala mentioned in more than one place in his book, the Quran, Al-Yada. So it actually amazes me that Al-Imam Al-Tirmidhi mentioned three characteristics here. And if you look at these three characteristics, they are three different characteristics. Okay? So this is Al-Yada, and this is Sam'a, and this is Al-Basara. The ones who know the deviated group, the Asha'ira, Asha'ira affirm, as they claim, Al-Sam'a and Wal-Basara. So Al-Sam'a Wal-Basara are from the seven characteristics that the Asha'ira affirm, which are known as, which they call Sifat Datiya. As for Al-Yada, they don't affirm it. But it amazes me that Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi mentions all three of them together. And look what he says after it, okay? To show you that the belief of this one and this one and this one should all be the same, look what he says. And he's not talking about the Asha'ira, but he's talking about the Jahmiyyah. He says, فَتَأَوَّلَتِ الْجَهْمِيَّةُ هَذِهِ الْآيَاتِ وَفَسَّرُوهَا عَلَى غَيْرِ مَا فَسَّرَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ. Okay, so the Jahmiyyah, they distorted. The ta'wil here doesn't mean التفسير, because it comes in one of those meanings. Here it means التحريف, the Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah mentions in his kitab, in his مجموع الفتاوى, when he was speaking about his كتاب العقيدة الواسطية. فتأولت الجهمية, the Jahmiyya distorted هذه الآيات, these verses that came regarding Allah's characteristics and attributes. وفسروها على غير ما فسر أهل العلم, and they explained it to be other than that which the people of knowledge explained it. So who is he referring to, أهل العلم here? Let's just go up. Oh, there they are. قولوا أهل العلم من أهل السنة. So Jahmiyya are going against أهل العلم, who he means by أهل السنة. وقالوا, they said, meaning who does this قال وقالوا go back to? It goes back to the Jahmiyya. إن الله لم يخلق آدم بيده. The Jahmiyya said, Allah did not create Adam with his hand. وقالوا, they also said, إنما معنى اليد, that the meaning of يد means ها هنا here, القوة. It means قوة, strength. Now what's funny is that the translation of اليد mean قوة, or explaining يد to be قوة, this is actually one of the belief of the Asha'ira. But if we look here, Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi is saying that to explain yad to mean quwa is tafsirun jahmi. It's a jahmi tafsir. So what a lot of scholars have taken and believe is that the Asha'ira of today are actually jahmiya. They are jahmiya. So Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah shows that this is a jahmi meaning. وقال إسحاق بن إبراهيم, يعني إسحاق بن راهويا. إسحاق بن إبراهيم is here. إسحاق بن إبراهيم, إسحاق بن راهويا, أما إسحاق بن راهويا, however you want to say it. Some who say راهويا, they say it in accordance to the wazn of سيبويا. And those who say إسحاق بن راهويا, they say according to how أهل الحديث say it. على كل حال, they said, قال إسحاق بن إبراهيم, who is شيخ البخاري, he says إنما يكون التشبيه. So the تشبيه is, and I have to just mention إسحاق بن إبراهيم, he is the teacher of Imam al-Bukhari, and he's the one who brought the idea to the mind of Imam al-Bukhari to write صحيح البخاري. He's the one who brought it to his mind. So this is not a normal Imam. Okay, so you have to know this. وقال إسحاق بن إبراهيم said إنما يكون التشبيه إذا قال يد كيد أو مثل يد أو سمع كسمع أو مثل سمع. فإذا قال سمع كسمع, فإذا قال سمع كسمع أو مثل سمع, فهذا التشبيه. So Imam إسحاق بن راهوية mentions to us, if a person says that Allah تبارك وتعالى has a hand like a hand, or like a hand, or he says Allah has a hearing like a hearing. So the kafiya and the mithl are just roughly the same meaning. Allah hears like that hearing. Or Allah tabarak wa ta'ala hears like that hearing. Or Allah has a hand like that hand. Then he says, فَإِذَا قَالَ سَمْعٌ كَسَمْعٍ أَوْ مِثْلُ سَمْعٍ فَهَذَا التَّشْبِيهُ. All of those falls under tashbih. وَأَمَّا إِذَا قَالَ, but if he says, كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ, as Allah said, يَدٌ, Allah has a hand, وَسَمْعٌ, Allah has a hearing, وَبَصَرٌ, Allah has a hearing, Allah has a seeing, so Allah has a hearing and Allah sees, وَلَا يَقُولُ, and he doesn't say كَيْفَ, how, وَلَا يَقُولُ مِثْلَ, and he doesn't use the word مِثْلَ سَمْعٍ, وَلَا كَسَمْعٍ, and he doesn't say like a hearing, فَهَذَا لَا يَكُولُ تَشْبِيهًا, that's not تَشْبِيه. وَهُوَ كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى فِي كِتَابِهِ, and that is what Allah said in his book, ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. So this ayah refutes two groups of people. This part of the verse, it is refuting the mushabbiha, those who make Allah tabarak wa ta'ala similar to his creation. And this part of the verse is refuting the mu'attila, those who don't want to give Allah tabarak wa ta'ala his characteristics which he has affirmed for himself. So tashbihun, a refutation on the mushabbiha, by telling them that Allah's characteristics is not similar to the characteristics of the creation. And this is a refutation on the mu'attila, those who want to not give Allah tabarak wa ta'ala any characteristics whatsoever. Anything I have said that was wrong, a mistake, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ بَرِيئَانِ مِنْهُ, is from me and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are free from it. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ.